Hey,
they're not bad kids. They just want help. That's all they want.
Could it be a food that they're eating? Could it be something that they're smelling, the odor of a chemical, the odor of pollution? Or could it be an ordinary allergen such as dust or mites or pollen, which is in particular causing a change in the way a child behaves, the way a child acts, the child's ability to learn?
The diagnosis and treatment of hyperactivity and behavior and learning problems in children due to certain foods and chemicals has been the lifelong work of Dr. Doris Rapp of Buffalo, a distinguished author, an internationally known pediatric allergist and doctor of environmental medicine for more than three decades.
There are a group of physicians who are specializing in what's called environmental medicine. And basically what we do is we do a newer, more precise way of allergy testing. And we test the youngster in the arm just the same way as I did for the first 18 years in practice, except instead of putting in 10 or 20 foods or things that cause allergies at one time, I put in one item at a time.
How do you test a patient?
There is a subset of children, a group of children who can't act and behave normally, who appear to have difficulties precipitated by eating certain foods, and you can either take the food out of their diet or you can treat them for the food sensitivity. Not always and not in every child, but in many children you can. Usually what we do is after we've tested the patient for several items and produced reactions and eliminated them, then we combine these together and we treat the patients either by an injection of that material, which is a stock allergy extract of the same type that most allergists use, or we treat them with drops under the tongue.
How scientific is this testing?
I use the same allergy extracts that I'm using now, except that I used to skin test everything all at once on both arms. I used to skin test with 1 to 10 dilutions. I now skin test one item at a time. I skin test with 1 to 5 dilutions, so I'm much more precise. That's why I say that this is a more precise way of doing it. And I check the patient much more carefully than I ever did before. Before, you would just look at the arm, read the reactions, and make up your extract and send the patient home. Now we have to watch the pulse and the drawing and the handwriting and how the patient looks and the color of their ears and their cheeks. And there are a lot of things that we monitor constantly, and so it's a much more time-consuming thing. This is not solid scientific evidence, but it certainly is suggestive that this form of treatment is helpful in certainly some patients. Again, not all patients.
What patterns should one look for, say, by a parent or a teacher?
One clue that is very good in children, and also helpful, I might add, in adults, are the patients who, when they eat a food to which they're sensitive, or they're exposed to some odor to which bothers them, their ears become bright red, either one or both, and this is as true for adults as it is for children. They develop dark blue, red, or black eye circles. They get bags under their eyes right here or right here in young children. Many times their cheeks will become bright red, looks like two red rouge-like cheek patches. And then other things that parents might recognize is they have this allergic salute, they wiggle their nose, they become congested, they make funny throaty sounds, or they...
Now you have explained some of the physical signs. What about some of the behavioral signs?
The typical child that has this kind of problem, although it can be a constant problem, the parents notice that it's a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. The child is lovely and just very nice and minds, and then all of a sudden you say, would you pick up that toy, or would you put away your pajamas, or would you take care of this, and the child absolutely explodes. You say, it's time to go to bed, and they get down on their back, and they kick their legs, and they throw their toys, and they scream, or they start bouncing into the furniture, or they attack the mother. Frequently, the mothers are battered. They attack the mother or the younger child, and they bite and hit and spit and kick and scream, and sometimes they whine.
Does this reaction affect learning, like writing or drawing?
When children lose control, frequently their handwriting, which is nice and normal and exact and correct, will become big and scrawly if they tend to be the hyperactive ones and it's all over the place. Many times they write upside down, backwards, in mirror images. The writing is not normal. And then when you treat the child by either stopping the food or treating them with the correct dilution of allergy extract, the exact item that caused the problem, the writing goes back down to normal. These children will tend to draw knives with blood dripping off of it and guns and people shooting and kicking. And then when you treat them appropriately, it goes back to normal. There are scientific studies done by myself and others that clearly document that foods can cause unusual reactions that affect more than the nose and the lungs and the skin. Chemical avoidance, I never really realized before, but that's definitely coming into vogue right now. There are people when they stop at a stoplight or at a toll bridge where there's a lot of auto exhaust fumes, they become ill. There are people who every time they go up in an airplane, they get sick when the plane lands and takes off. And this is because the fumes from the airplane are sucked into the cabin at that time and you can smell it. And I think as time goes on, we're going to find that more and more things that we don't think about, like aerial spraying of the neighborhood trees, like asphalting the street in front of your house, like using all these chemical sprays on your lawn, like filling your walls full of formaldehyde foam. And what we have to do is we have to have an increased awareness on everyone's part that when somebody feels fine and suddenly they don't feel fine and the doctors haven't got a ready answer, they have to start to think, what did I eat? What did I touch? What did I smell?